Let's look a bit more in depth at how this box and space actually gets positioned and defined internally. First, we define our camera object as looking down the world's negative z-axis and oriented so that the top of the camera is facing along the plus y-axis. The camera starts at the origin, just like other objects. The first step is to move the camera to where we want to make an image from. We also tilt and orient the camera as desired. This is similar to how we've been orienting objects all along. We define some sort of rotation and translation to get the camera into place. We ignore scale, we're just trying to set up the camera in space. Giving the camera a position is simple enough. To compute the rotation needed to orient our camera, we use what's called a LookAt system. This is pretty much what it sounds like. You define a target location for what direction you want the camera to look. This defines the negative z-axis for the camera's frame of reference, in other words, how it's pointing in the world. So here I have a real live camera. It even works. And with my z-axis here, that tells me which way it's pointing, but unfortunately it doesn't tell me which way is up. It still has this 1 degree of freedom. So what we do is we also define an up vector of some sort. This vector gives us some guidance as to which way to orient the top of the camera. Typically in 3JS, we'll pass in a vector such as 0, 1, 0, the plus y-axis, as the up vector. Given our view vector and this up vector, we'd like to form a matrix that defines a whole frame of reference for our camera. We know where we want the z-axis to look along, but we want to know where the camera's y and x-axis end up. By specifying a general up direction, we do this. For example, say we have a camera pointing in some direction, looking along its negative z-axis. If we give an up direction, we can find the direction pointing to the right of the camera, which is the x-axis, by taking the cross product of this z-axis and our up vector. Now we have two axes locked down, camera z and camera x. We can find the true up direction, the camera's y-axis, by then taking the cross product of the x and z axes. Remember that the cross product of two vectors will give us a vector that's perpendicular to both of them. This may all sound a bit odd and like a lot of work, but is extremely common. It's probably the place where I use the cross product the most. The whole point here is that, given a view direction and an up vector as a hint, we can get a frame of reference for the camera. We'll often use the world's plus y-axis as our up vector hint, but it all depends. Say we're a hawk soaring over some terrain. We're looking straight down, which would be looking down the y-axis of our world. If we use the world's y-axis as our hint, it doesn't make much sense. We define the negative z-axis the camera is looking along and the y-axis for the camera's up direction as vectors in exactly opposite directions. This is not very useful. In this case, our up vector is more like the direction pointing out of the top of our hawk's head, the direction it's flying. Now that the up vector is not parallel to the look-at direction, we can form a good frame of reference for the hawk.